Kickoff brings us to the desert southwest, Glendale, Arizona, and State Farm Stadium.
Tonight we continue with Wild Card Weekend with what should be a great one
between the Washington football team
and the Arizona Cardinals.
Win or go home is the mantra, and off we go. We're underway in this NFC Wild Card game. And he's up across the 25 and down. At the 28.
For first and 10 at their own 28-yard line.
Some space, and it turned out to be a nice play for the offense.
Here's the first carry for Kenyon Drake, and he'll get this only up to about the 35. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a 3rd and 3.
Now that's a mountain of a man that just made that stop, isn't it? But he's more than that. This guy's nimble and quick, more than a space eater. He just made a great play there.
Murray gonna run play action with Drake and look to throw it. Try to force it to Hopkins, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Fabian Moreau. And he will bring this one back. It is a pick six for a Washington touchdown. And we'll see if that pick six looms large as this game continues, because we've seen plays like that alter a lot of playoff contests over the years.
I would agree with that totally. And you often think to yourself, why did it alter it so much? Because after games, don't we hear coaches and players say, well, one play doesn't usually determine the outcome? But I don't think that's really true to you, because there's times when we see plays like that, and all of a sudden the momentum jumps to that team side, it deflates the other side, and they never pick it back up. And then things really go from there, don't they?
That's the thing for me. We talk about momentum changes. A play like that is the ultimate momentum change.
At their own 20-yard line.
Arizona's offense at the line, ready to get their drive started. They've been a come-from-behind team all year. They'll need to do it again as they trail early in this wild card game. And he'll be corralled right around the 34. First down yardage on the first play of the drive, given 14. The CD a lot of times like to separate speed and quickness, and they've got a back that's both. We know that he's fast in the open field, but man, his first step is so quick, too.
It is something, isn't it? Because you think of that type of speed getting to the perimeter and turning upfield, but also when you run those inside runs, he can get into the secondary so fast, the linebackers don't have a chance to react.
Really nice gain of 25 yards. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Murray again. This is Drake. He'll fight forward for a couple down inside the 40.
Oh, that's a real nice job there by the defensive front. They just engaged and held their ground. But how about the guy who made the play? We often talk about whether they take a good first step or not. Many times you just don't take any step. Just get your feet moving, get your body going. And then once he made the read, he was able to make the play.
Drake again, the ball carrier.
2 yards on the first down carry, and then followed up by 2 yards on the second down carry.
Well, that's definitely not going to be enough to get the job done. Wasn't the expression 3 yards in a cloud of dust?
Now they're going to need 6 on third down to keep the drive going. Throwing is Murray on third down. And that will be incomplete.
Well, one thing things for sure. When you get a big receiver and you trust him downfield, you're going to give him opportunities to go up and get that 50-50 ball.
And he is a darn good big receiver. Unfortunately, that time didn't work out. Nice job defensively. Gonzalez's kick is good. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. These kickers now, used to be that a 50-plus yarder was cause for celebration, now seemingly automatic.
Isn't it funny, when we prepare for a game, when you look at the backgrounds of these kickers, it's interesting, isn't it, to find out they were All-State quarterbacks, receivers, defensive backs, All-State wrestlers, right, baseball players. We're finding athletes all along, and now they're just specialists putting it through the posts.
And the Washington offense going to come up here first and 10 at the 20. And he'll get this up to the 34-yard line. They may want to go back to that one. First play of the drive, good for 15 and a first down.
That's pretty much meat and potatoes right there, wasn't it? Just go right at him and let your big horse charge up the middle. Not too fancy there, was it?
Nothing fancy at all. Challenging that defense. And on that go-around, the offense won the challenge. And that'll be knocked away. It's incomplete. The intended receiver was Thaddeus Moss. But it'll be second down. From the shotgun, here's an inside give. And the hole closes quickly. He gets it across the 35 to the 36-yard line. They do get a couple, but they'll be left staring at a 3rd and 8 coming up. The Cards going nickel. An extra defensive back out there now on 3rd down. Out of the shotgun, Haskins. Oh, he almost picked him. Nearly a turnover there on their opening drive. That's a throw he'd like to have back. Now 4th down. So on 4th down, Washington going to call on Tress Way to punt it away. That'll go as a punt of 34 yards that time. And the Cards will take over 1st and 10.
At their own 28-yard line.
Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. And fortunate to get points on the board last night. They had to hit a really long field goal to do so.
The kickers in today's game are so good and so skilled and hit from distances that we almost start to take them for granted. And we can't do that. That's a long field goal that they got 3 points out of. They've got to feel good about that. And they better make sure they love him up because he's helped them out.
Yeah, now we'll see if that offense can put 6 on the board here. We'll see. Him right around the 43.
The ball carrier.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off. A pretty decent gain.
It's a pickup of 6. Brings up 2nd and 4.
Six yards on that last play. Here's 2nd and 4. Now Murray, he bootlegs it. Throwing middle, but it's incomplete. Christian Kirk, the man he was looking for, but now it'll be 3rd down.
I didn't like the look of that play right from the beginning. I thought he should have seen the coverage that was there, tried to force it in. That one, he's fortunate, just fell incomplete.
Face a 3rd down and 4 after that incompletion on 2nd down. From the gun, Murray. Buying time to his left. He may try and run for this. But he is out of bounds.
runs, but not before he's inside the 30. Opted to run for it. The decision a good one. Picking up the first, getting 14 yards on the scramble. 9-yard line. Down. It's Drake. Credit him with a 1-yard gain there to make it second and 9.
No doubt about it. Really nice job there by the defense, not allowing him to get to the perimeter. But that means your defensive ends, your outside linebackers, the guys that you pay big money to sack the quarterback. They also have to have interest in the running game as well. They did a nice job there of holding the point of attack and not giving ground.
Well, they're making an effort to get the ground game going tonight. So far, it's working.
I like what we're seeing from the offensive line. They seem to have the leverage going, and they're controlling things and reestablishing the line of scrimmage, moving that defensive front backwards. I also like what the runner's giving this to. It appears that he's been waiting all day long to get out here and take off.
His first catch of this wild card game, and it's good for a first down. Zone. Here's the Heisman Trophy winner, Murray, escaping the pressure right. He's going to hit his man out of the backfield, complete. Now Drake loses the football, and it's Washington that scoops it up, and he's going to return it to the 21-yard line. Always costly to cough up that football. These defenders, they become so adept, though, at jarring it free.
Yeah, it's amazing that there aren't more fumbles caused, because now, if you're an offensive player, you go through ball security drills every single day. It's really not out of line to think that you should take the ball to bed with you and just hold on to it. But the bottom line is, no matter how much you try to protect it, these guys are pretty good at finding ways to knock it out.
Second and 10 now, Haskins. Oh, he got position on him, and he pulls it in. That one good for a first down pickup of 18 yards. He missed on his first three passes, was 0 for 3. Now gets a connection. Maybe that'll get him going.
Yeah, it wasn't a time for panic, but there was some concern because once you start in a certain pattern, you wonder, can you get out of it? And that flips the other way, too, when you're throwing it really well. In this case, now he's got his first completion. They think he might be off to the races.
Brings up second and 10.
So line of scrimmage, still a 39 on second and 10. To throw again. Haskins. That's complete to Moss out of the backfield. And he's going to be taken down here with a penalty flag on the field. That's a good chunk of yardage. It's going to be canceled out.
And we always talk about hidden yardage in a game. That's going to count as that because now it doesn't go on the books. But now they have to make that up again, don't they?
Haskins back to the air. Got his man. It's Tyrell Williams. And he'll get up near the 45. They'll spot it at the 44.
Tyrell Williams.
But it appears that they read man defense and went to the out route. And what you have to do on that one is the receiver's got to make sure he works the defender towards the middle of the field to give himself space to cut to the outside and have that ball delivered with good timing. And they got it.
And he'll be corralled out across midfield down to the 45.
Complete to Tyrell Williams.
So into Cardinal territory now. It's first and 10 at the 45-yard line. After one, 7-3 the score on EA Sports.
Cardinals 3.
On first and 10, it's Haskins. That's complete. Terry McLaurin with it. Touchdown, Washington. Terry McLaurin, 45 yards. And Washington is able to stretch their lead.
I know these wide receivers are about flash and dash and high-flying plays, but a good number of them played running back at some point in their career, and that's how they finish off a lot of their big plays, run after the catch.
And this time he finishes off the big play in the end zone. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback.
5-yard line.
Murray and the Cardinals with a first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. And from the shotgun, he'll throw. This one caught by Isabella. And he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35. Give him
from 10 yards there, and about by the nose of the football, he's going to have a first down.
First and 10 at the 35-yard line.
Murray now. He'll set up the screen to Drake. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. The play goes for 19 yards. Gives him a new set of downs. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Now Drake. Defensively, a solid response after giving up back to.
Scrimmage left him no space to try and run. Really nice job swarming to the ball carrier.
On second and 9, Murray, that ball complete to Isabella. And they're going to have another first down here as the tackle's made at Washington's 9-yard line. 34-yard line from the 34 now. Here's first and 10. Here's Murray. And that's going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down.
Yeah, that one sailed on him. You've got to make sure you give your receiver a chance to come down inbounds because they are very gifted. They'll make the circus catches, but they make them out of bounds. That does you no good.
Murray gets this one to Isabella. 9 yards, and that leaves him just short, so it'll be third and less than a yard.
But that's what you're looking for when you want to throw the ball downfield. You want one of those guys who can play out on the perimeter, can play out wide, who can not only get open, but when they're covered, can uncover themselves downfield and create catches.
And he is in the end zone. Touchdown, Arizona. Taking it in for 24 yards out. And the Cardinals draw a bit closer. So they went to the ground game on third, hoping to pick up the first. They also picked up a touchdown.
Offensive linemen so used in this situation to have a pass back. You're looking at what it is, third down. They don't care that it's third and whatever. They figure they're going to throw the ball. And when you call a running play, I think you need to energize it. I can juice them up because I haven't met offensive linemen yet. They like to pass block more than they like to run block. And they opened up some nice holes there for him. And he took it to the house.
Out there set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked. But you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
Brings up second and 7.
3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and 7. Now a handoff here to his running back. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down.
And that's a nice pickup of a first down on that second down run. And at that yardage gained, they can run that plan any down.
They go play action here on first down. Connects here with a tight end, Jeremy Sprinkle. And he finally goes down at the 23-yard line.
Complete to Jeremy Sprinkle.
Big yardage that time for Washington. 41 yards. So the big play gets him all the way down to the outskirts of the red zone here for first and 10. Haskins. Over the middle, he's got Tyrell Williams. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. 11 more on that one, and another first down.
Washington.
Here's Haskins out of the gun. Oh, that was dangerous. Threw it into coverage, almost picked. But instead, they'll keep it on second down.
Pretty nice coverage there, but a missed opportunity for an interception. Let's face it, a lot of these defenders, they've got it all. Speed, athleticism, hands, a little bit questionable.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Throwing again. Haskins looking end zone, but it's incomplete.
The strong windows get a lot tighter near the end zone, don't they? And here's the thing. You already probably
simply have 3 points in your hip pocket, you force a throw here and give up an interception, you come away with nothing.
Especially tough in the middle third of the field where he threw that one. Third down, here's Haskins. And this is taken in for a Washington touchdown. Terry McLaurin, two catches, two touchdowns here so far. And Washington going to add on to their lead.
A lot of people might call this backyard football. Sometimes just understanding who you've got out wide and who you're going to throw it to. Give him an opportunity to go up and make a play, even when contested. Looks like that one worked out pretty well. The trust factor in effect.
It's good, and it's 21-10.
Makes this Washington 21, Cardinals 10.
Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And tackled at the 21-yard line, so a net negative there of 4 yards.
At their own 21-yard line.
Arizona's offense at the line, ready to get their drive started. They'll look to make some inroads here, trailing 21-10 as they come up on a first and 10. A throw left side to start the drive is complete. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. The drive starting with a first down, 11 yards on that pickup.
That certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
So apparently some grabbing of the jersey there on the O-line.
Yeah, just look in the interior, and that's where the penalty occurred.
They're backed up here with a first and 20 now after the holding penalty. Shotgun now for Murray. Over the middle, complete. That's Drake. And he's brought down after a very nice game. That'll wind up a gain of 27 on the catch and run.
Got a strong throw and catch right there. And so far in this game, the alleys have been open for them to get completions, and they're taking advantage of it.
Oh, ball batted in the air, and now it's intercepted. Picked off by Ronald Darby.
When a team's turned it over 3 times in the first half, we just look at the offense and say, guys, what are you doing? But instead, we really should be looking at the defense. They've created the takeaways. 2 interceptions, 1 caused fumble. They played awfully well swarming to the ball here in the first half.
He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's 2nd and 4.
He was brought down at the 28-yard line. A 6-yard pickup.
Second quarter action with 1:59 remaining. Coming up at the half, we remind you that we're going to do what we've done all year. We'll get you down to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. Coach will have the lowdown on what's going on here in this wild card weekend as we begin the road to the upcoming Super Bowl. And he will lose yardage on the play, back at his own 19-yard line. The Cardinals going to use the first of their timeouts. So as they take it over, we step aside. That last completion, certainly not what they were hoping for, as now they'll try to convert on third. Now Haskins to throw it. And a throw there going to be incomplete. Byron Murphy, the first pick of the 2nd round there defensively.
As a defensive back, you have some weapons at your disposal that we don't often talk about. And you can read the receiver's eyes, you can read his hands, and you know that the arrival of the ball is imminent, and that allows you to make a play on it and oftentimes knock it away.
A very good kick there, but 15 yards on the return. And that will come the offense as they take over.
At their own,
ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. And the interception last time on the opponent's side of the field, certainly not what they want.
So frustrating because that signifies there's a drive going on. You're in good spot.
Murray throwing left side, it's complete, and he's down inside the 5. completion. He's now north of 200 yards here in the first half. Boy, a tough start for the secondary defensively.
It is, and it's got to put a dent in their confidence. And, you know, you always want to keep that up and feel like you can always bounce back after plays. But with the kind of numbers he's putting up here, it's starting to wear on them a little bit, I think. So they're looking at each other and trying to figure out what defense will work and how can they play better without getting beat deep for big passes.
Second and goal from the one. They'll try and pound it in with Drake. And he is in for six. Touchdown, Cardinals. Kenyon Drake with his second touchdown here in this first half. And the Cardinals have cut it to within a score. Gonzalez good on the extra point. And it's now 21-17. Now after the touchdown, here's Gonzalez on to kick it away. Taking it about the one. And he'll go down as this drive will start at the 25-yard line.
At their own 25-yard line.
Set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. And you're under a minute to go here in the half. Field position not really in your favor, but still time to try and move the ball and get in field goal range.
Yeah, you've got the lead. It's definitely a thought. Let's go ahead and try and increase it. But at the same time, I don't like the odds. I don't like where they are in the field. Got the lead. They've done well in the first half. Don't mess it up and go into halftime looking at each other wondering what if.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. To throw again. Haskins. That'll be caught. It's Steven Sims. Washington now going to use the first of their three timeouts as they stop it with 28 seconds to go in the first half of play. Here's Moss with a catch out of the backfield. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. Now Washington going to use the second of their three timeouts as it comes with 22 seconds to go here in half number one. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Off the play fake. Here's Haskins. Slings this deep from McLaurin. Oh, so close to an interception. Read that beautifully. Got his hands on it. Couldn't get it. And it's second down.
He certainly had a good game throwing the ball so far, but I think he was trying to take that from good to great with that throw, trying to get one downfield.
He'll air this one out deep for Sims. And that one almost intercepted. Call it a 50-50 ball. It falls incomplete and now third down.
Isaiah Simmons there defensively.
So back-to-back incompletions, and that has him staring at a third and 10. Again, it's Haskins. And that'll be incomplete with just 6 seconds left on the clock. Dustin Hopkins now for the Washington field goal. This officially a 55-yard attempt. And he has got it from 55 yards away. That was never in doubt. So a big play before the end of the half to get him into this spot, and they cash in with three.
How about the 1-2 to the solar plexus on that one? The big play, the field goal, not much time left on the clock. That's the way to go into the half.
So we come upon halftime here in this NFC wildcard matchup. As now we send you out to Orlando and hook back up with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report.
Saint Gonzalez to kick off for Arizona.
One of these two teams about to play their final half of the season as we're back at it in this NFC wildcard bout. Fielded near the back of the end zone. And he will not bring it out. It's a touchback. here, set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense.
We have not seen much on offense here from either side these last few drives. We've hit a wall, so to speak.
And hit it hard, haven't we? Because the defenses right now, they seem to be a step ahead, don't they? Beating them to the point of attack, beating them to the punch. These offensive guys, they're tinkering like crazy. What's it going to take to get back on track?
Yeah, both sides searching for adjustments. And now here's a deep shot that's complete.
Oh, that was sweet.
Touchdown, Washington. Tyrell Williams, 74 yards.
And Washington able to stretch that lead out even further. They talked about stringing together some explosive plays here in the playoffs. That was a pretty explosive play.
It certainly was. And if you're going to win on the road, it certainly helps to have big playability in your hip pocket, doesn't it?
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away.
Taking it about the one. And it takes this near the 25. Just a little pass there. Call it the 26.
At their own 26-yard line.
Arizona's offense at the line, ready to get their drive started. I guess they have to feel a little gratified to at least get on the board last time, but still work to do.
No doubt about it. I wonder now if they're going to try to increase the urgency a little bit, maybe pump up the pace, maybe go 2 minutes. Who knows? Let's see what they decide to do.
Across the 30-yard line. Nice work to get seven out of that, and it's second down. From the gun, Murray. Oh, he almost had it.
Murray's pass.
Already with one interception, just missing his second there.
And those two just haven't been in sync thus far. They've done a nice job against him, but still, with his talent, you would expect him to have more completions to him in this game.
Murray going to try to throw on third down. Maybe he hits him in stride. And he will be very close to a first down, but I see the closed fist of the referee. And that means fourth down.
Fourth down.
So in their own territory, but they only need a few inches, so they're going to opt to go for this thing. We'll see. Maybe a surprise pass, a run. What will they do? We're about to find out. Fourth down. And it's going to be batted down, and we'll go the other way with the football. So certainly an interesting call there to go for it.
And Washington will take control of the football in great field position.
On first down, it's Gibson. And down right around the 32-yard line, 4 yards on the pickup.
Not a whole lot there. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run-pass option.
You get the sense that next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one, huh?
The run got four. Now they deal with a second and six. They'll keep it on the ground. Gibson. And he's going to be stopped up just short of the first down at the Cardinals 23. 9 yards on the pickup there, and it keeps the drive alive.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
And he's going to lose yardage and be backed up to the 25. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
It's a loss of two. Brings up
second and 12. Haskins. Now what a slant to McLaurin. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line.
Terry McLaurin.
They get 11 back on that one. It leads to third down.
And it's third down.
Haskins, and that is caught. Touchdown, Washington.
Complete to
Thaddeus Moss.
Touchdown.
There to make the grab. And Washington is able to stretch their lead. He's been a busy man, 5 for 5 now, as he knocks another one through to extend the lead.
Cardinals 17.
The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away.
Taking it about the one. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line.
At their own 30-yard line.
Ready to go with their next drive and at the line, the Cardinal offense. And last time this unit was out here, costly turnover, and then that turned into 6 points. They get DeAndre Hopkins, he's all alone. Touchdown, Cardinals. DeAndre Hopkins, 70 yards. And the Cardinals cut into that lead. Well, if they're going to make a game of this in the second half, they need a few big plays to go their way. That's one.
And the way to get it done is to also conserve time. So to your point, that big play right there, now you're not moving the ball downfield, taking time off the clock. You're leaving yourself a better avenue to continue to try and make a comeback.
Fielded near the back of the end zone. And this will not be brought out. It's a touchback.
At their own 25-yard line.
Haskins and the Washington offense going to come up here first and 10 at their 25-yard line. From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. And he's upended after a gain of two out to the 27.
He was taken down.
2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8.
I know we can't hear what's going on in that hole right now, but I guarantee you at least one offensive lineman is saying, my bad, we simply couldn't move him off the line of scrimmage. We've got to do a better job trying to root those guys out of there.
Washington.
They'll run on first down. It's Gibson, and he'll work it across midfield inside the 45. 11 more yards that go around, a first down as well.
I'm not sure how much more evidence they need, partner, than to understand that if they don't start to slow him down, it's going to be a long afternoon here at the stadium because he is just shredding them at this point. And let's face it, coming into the game, they knew he would be the focal point of their attack. This is going to take an 11-man unit on the defensive side to start making plays.
Looking to throw again on second down. Haskins, and he almost had it defensively. Could have been a game changer there in the second half. Instead, it's third down.
Third down and 8 yards to go.
Shotgun, Haskins. Hard throw, incomplete.
That'd be a little bit of frustration there. Back-to-back incompletions. Receivers blanketed on both attempts. This time on third down.
Here's Tressway now as he's on to punt for Washington. It's a wobbler here. A special teams mistake there, no doubt. Just 26 yards officially on the punt. And the Cards are going to have the football with a first and 10 deep in their own territory. They'll start the drive with Drake. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little game. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it second and 4.
Brings up second and 4.
Out of the gun, here's Murray. Steps away to his left. And that's going to be incomplete.
Oh, I like that right there. Not only was it the right play, throwing it away like that, frankly, I think it was the only play.
Yeah, got outside of the pocket, realized he had nothing, just chucked it free.
Yeah, live to fight another down, right?
Got a man over the middle, it's Williams. And they're going to mark him down short, maybe by about a yard, if that. They stop him for only 3 that time, and that'll bring up 4th down. Here's Dustin Colquitt now, as he's on to punt for the... And they're going to fake it from deep in their own territory. And this is incomplete. A huge gamble, and it does not pay off. They fake the punt. It doesn't work out. And now possession's going to go over with a football at the 20-yard line. Check 59, right? Haskins looking to throw on first down. A hit as he throws there, incomplete. The intended receiver was Thaddeus Moss, but it's going to be second down.
Oh, that's got to frustrate him a little bit because they nearly got to him there, and it would have been the first sack of the game instead. They're able to influence the release, and they did force the incomplete pass.
Second and 10 now, Haskins, and that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down.
And that's one of those plays where it's hard to keep two eyes on the football when you know the contact's coming, let alone getting two hands around it, hugging it to your body, and absorbing the hit, even for those big tight ends who you would think could absorb that contact.
To throw on third down. Haskins, and that is incomplete.
From the snap, he certainly looked like he knew where he wanted to go with the ball, but surprise, that guy was covered. So that took his attention elsewhere to no avail.
A 37-yard attempt.
Hopkins' kick is good. And that'll push the lead up to 17. So good snap, good hold, and right down the middle.
Never in doubt, just the way you used to hit him, partner.
You mean like kicking the ball?
Exactly.
Well, that was in high school.
Doesn't matter. I don't care what level. You hit them, they go through.
The Cardinals take over first and 10 at their own 20-yard line.
Arizona's offense at the line, ready to get their drive started. Drake will start the drive on the ground. A solid run on first down, gain of 7, leaves him with a second and 3.
Well, no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
Operating from the 27 now, here's second and 3. He's going to air one out. And on the left sideline, he caught it, but out of bounds, according to the headline. Incomplete, so the ball a little late getting there, and it's third down. And the coach has decided to challenge this play. He has tossed down the red flag. Well, he challenged the play. It did not pay off.
And that means he lost a timeout in that challenge.
And as a coach, you hate that. Don't know if you took the advice of the player, you threw it yourself, but it didn't go your way.
At the end of the day, it all comes back to the head coach. He has the final determination on whether to actually challenge the play or not. In this case, it didn't pay off for him.
And that's got to be so heartbreaking. You throw that flag, you probably feel really confident, and then all of a sudden, boom, you lose the challenge.
Yeah, when you take a look at it, you're throwing that flag because you believe you're going to be right. And when it comes back the other way, you have to regroup.
Well, at this stage of the game in the second half, down 3 scores, I guess they felt like they needed to push.
And let's face it, with this deficit, if they give up another score here after they didn't get it, does it really matter?
Right.
It really doesn't. They had to go and try and make something happen if they had any chance of winning this game.
On first down, Gibson. And not much of a hole there as he gets it down to about the 24-yard line.
The tackle made by
Devondre Campbell.
Well, that's just a pile of bodies there, and that's when you kind of find out who's a tough guy, right? Who can stand up and make a play. It was only a 3-yard run, but for both sides, they had to walk away from that feeling like, okay, I can stand up when the going gets tough in here.
And not much. Maybe a yard down to the 23. Not much on that run, Charles.
No, that's exactly the way to execute a run blitz there. They guessed correctly that they would move the ball on the ground, honed in on it, and stopped them. Marked that down for a win in the defense's column.
On third down, Haskins. Now he's going to drop this one down to Gibson. And they'll work it inside the 15-yard line before it's all said and done. 10 yards there. Good for Washington. First down.
First down, Washington.
Throwing now, Haskins on first down. Find Williams on the slant. And he'll be brought down on what's going to turn out to be the final play of this third quarter. One quarter remains in this NFC wild card matchup. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he fights his way into the end zone. Touchdown, Washington.
Punching it in from a yard away.
And Washington going to add on to their lead.
Look, we all know that sometimes we see upsets in the wild card round. But I have to tell you, in this case, I did not see that coming.
I don't think anyone in the stadium saw it coming. You and I were coming in before the game. There was a couple in front of us talking about travel plans for next weekend. They might want to cancel those.
Yeah, I would say so, because right now it's looking more and more like they're going to be one and done. They're probably trying to call the hotel, make sure they get their security deposit back.
25-yard line.
Drive and at the line, the Cardinal offense. They are most likely staring at a cold end to their season here in this wild card round. Nothing has gone wrong.
And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down.
Montez Sweat able to run him down for a loss of 12 that time.
Well, so much for setting the tone of the drive offensively. Giving up a big sack that loses that kind of yardage, not a great start.
Now this throw caught left side. And he'll have this pass the 30 prior to going out of bounds. A good pickup there, 18 yards as they get closer for third down. The Cardinals on third down. They've converted 3 times and 8 chances. This is third and 4. And able to find Kirk complete. And he'll take this one in for the Arizona touchdown. Christian Kirk, 69 yards. Closer. Great corner route there. Not only able to catch it, turn it upfield, and get into the end zone.
It usually involves a little bit of an extra move, doesn't it? You've got to get them thinking that you're moving to the middle of the field and you're breaking away to that corner. Boy, that was well executed.
He's got it. Taking it about the 1. And he won't get this to the 20-yard line as he's down at the 19.
Washington will take over first and 10 at their own 19-yard line.
Out there, set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. And they are looking good. A 2-score lead here in this fourth quarter as they hope to capture a spot in the divisional round.
And intercepted. Maybe the turning point they need.
Picked off by Byron Murphy. And he will return this one to the 30-yard line. Well, this D, particularly the secondary, has been picked apart at points here tonight. They finally, though, get to the quarterback in a quarter.
And we know this about him. He loves night games, loves the spotlight, loves being the center of attention. I will bet you that he ran off the field almost chuckling to himself. They finally got one. They finally got me.
Oh, they've intercepted Murray for the 3rd time. Reuben Foster picks it. Both defenses have had their struggles, but they've been good enough to get them this lead and another nice play there to help preserve the lead.
It's been a game of punch counterpunch, hasn't it? All throughout. But this time, the big swing was taken and it didn't land. Nice play by them on defense.
And he struggles to get a yard here, maybe a yard, down to the 31. I'm sure that that's going to be the formula. Just keep the ball on the ground. Keep that clock moving.
And when you have the lead this late in the game, above all, stay in bounds. Yes, take care of the football. Yes, gain yardage, but stay in bounds and let that clock tick.
Now he's going to swing this one out to his running back.
In order for a screen pass to break big, a lot of things have to come together and be well executed. But all it takes is one small thing to go wrong and keep it from being a big game.
Washington on 3rd down, not quite 50%, 4 for 9. This will be 3rd and 5. And that will be incomplete.
Certainly looked like someone was very confident in his ability to fit that one in. I would say he was overconfident because there wasn't a whole lot of separation there. Had that one covered pretty well downfield and knocked it away.
And Hopkins' kick is good. And that will make make this now a 19-point advantage. So with that, you figure, yeah, this game's pretty much out of reach at this point.
Yeah, it's going to take a heck of a comeback to come from three scores down, but don't change that channel. Don't go away. Miracles can happen, and you want to be here in case it does.
You're a company man.
Aren't I, though?
And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully.
The Cardinals take over first and 10 at their own.
Arizona's offense at the line, ready to get their drive started. Saying their fans here are stunned would be an understatement. Things in this wild card round have not gone according to plan. Forced out to his left. Looking left side, and he's got a man. It's Drake. A lot of effort there for just a 3-yard gain, and now second down. From the gun, Murray being chased out left. And that one almost intercepted. Far too loose with the football here. Nearly a fourth pick. And it's third down.
They'll probably spend a little extra time dissecting the game film after this one. I think the part of their plan was to hit him over the top of the deep ball. They've been unsuccessful all night.
Throwing is Murray on third down. Now he lets it go deep for Kirk. Well, this is taken in. It's complete. And he's going to have a Cardinals first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. They chalk that one up as a gain of 34 on third down. Again, they'll throw with Murray. Throw left side complete. That's Drake. He'll be hit down at the 33. 5 yards on the play.
It's a gain of 5. Brings up second and
Murray going to run play action with Drake and look to throw it. He lets this one fly toward the back of the end zone. Oh, he almost had it for the pick. A great chance there for the interception in the end zone. Instead, third down. Murray to air it out again. He'll take a shot for the end zone. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off by Fabian Moreau. And he is all the way up past the 25.
Intercepted.
Another solid game-changing play for this defense with the interception. At this point, though, I don't know that it's game-changing. I mean, they've got this one in firm control.
And you always hear about, you know, those stories about someone left their game plan behind and maybe you benefit from it. To say that that happened, but they certainly have appeared on defense to be a step ahead this entire game. Guys are always in the right spot in order to make a play.
The offense has had its moments too.
At the 37-yard,
they'll keep it on the ground. It's Gibson, and he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line. A gain of just a yard, but it's a first down.
Now that's the way to do it. Hand it to someone with vision and good footwork, and add in a little bit of power. And you find a way to pick up first downs.
Coming up on the final 2.5 minutes. And boy, has it been fun to watch this offense operate. Quite the display. And now they look to polish it off. And he pushes through a would-be tackler to get about 3 yards. Second down. The last run got 3. Now here's 2nd and 7. 2 minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So it's Washington with the football here as we welcome you back. And you'd have to figure they're just looking to burn these final 2 minutes away and get out of here with a victory. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down.
Taken down.
No gain on the play there, so they're left with a 3rd and 6.
As usual, the hallmark of a good run defense, linebackers making plays near the line of scrimmage. Absolutely nowhere to run there.
And on 3rd down, a nickel formation here defensively. Haskins out of the gun. A bullet throw, but incomplete.
So many offenses want to include their running backs into their passing offense and be able to swing the ball out and check it down to them. But sometimes those guys are just not as comfortable catching the ball as they are running it.
Woo! Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. Let's just be frank. They're playing for pride at this point.
that's all that's left, because victory, not a chance now. And I can't wait to see how they actually go about doing it, because there are a lot of people watching the body language of the guys on the field now, and if they call plays they want executed, they need to do that and do it really well.
And my goodness, another interception. Picked off by Troy Apke. Well, it wasn't always pretty, but the interception there, that means that they should get out of here with a victory.
Yeah, this is not a game that they're going to preserve for posterity on defense, but they did finish it off, didn't they? They did make the winning play to close things out. They'll take that one and head to the locker room.
The defense can stop it twice more as they take a knee here. The NFL on EA Sports. For more, log on to EASports.com. With that, we say good night from Glendale.